man. Y'all gonna go out. All this stuff the Pops did. He, man, you know, Reed don't play. He gotta go. And I thought for a minute they had me. I was like, man, they let that boy slide out to Cuba or, yeah, Cuba. Like, they let that man slide off scot-free to Cuba. Live a good life, you know. Sissy going shopping at the local market with the flower dress. I'm like, man, y'all let that all that. But yeah, you know. So yeah, man. I think the last show was solid, man, because they got so much stuff now that they leading into the next season. You know what I mean? You got Jerome and Louie, they issue. He talked crazy to Leon. You gonna basically tell me you gonna do what I tell you to do, because you know that's basically what he said. You know, to Leon. And then what about when he found out Reed still killed his pops? So that's a lot of stuff. It's a lot of stuff that's still like, oh man, hey, this season five, we want a season six or season five?
Four. It's gonna be going to season five.
Season five, I'm like, oh man, they still got a lot of story that's gonna be clean, because how they left off with the finale. And no, and I ain't even said about Mel, the man with the C Mel. I'm like, oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Most of the time, man, when you get to like season four, season five, the show start kind of tailing off, and you kind of see the writers really struggling trying to get some of the episodes off and some of the stories and plots. And I feel like this show is really just now kind of hitting their stride. They haven't hit their peak yet. They kind of hitting their stride, because, man, just walking in and kind of getting that Alton story kind of take it back from the beginning, when you kind of get that Alton story where he kind of come in with the Black Panther when he's back in the day, he's all cleaned up. You know, going in to see Franklin wanted to say the Pledge of Allegiance, and you kind of already know what he about. You're like, look, I ain't thinking about no Pledge of Allegiance, man. Come on, we finna get out of here. And then, you know what I'm saying, you see Franklin kind of like, hey, I want to be here with my friends. Like, hey, you gonna understand, and kind of give him that grown man talk, you know what I'm saying, as a little kid. But this whole episode was about Alton. What was gonna happen with Alton? Like, was he gonna be able to survive this episode, or were they gonna kind of, you know, hang it over our heads and kind of like bring it into season five? But you kind of see how Alton, you know, when you break it down to the basic nature of it, you kind of see how Alton would just want to protect Franklin as a pops, you know what I'm saying? He wanted to do that, but he went about it the wrong way. You know, he wanted to go about it as, all right, let me go expose the CIA. But he don't know, man, you can't expose a system that big and don't think there's going to be no ramification that comes from that.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. Like,
yeah. So he can't just go out there in the streets and just be, you know, saying all this, you know, this stuff off, you know, all these facts, you know, because he really caught Reed up, where he's like, look, I got pictures of Reed, you know what I'm saying? I know his real name. Then he said out his name. He's like, man, I know his real name. Put him out there. Yeah. You know, so you already know what time it was. You know, Reed wasn't going for that.
Reed wasn't going for that. Like, man, you knew it wasn't going to no get back. Reed knew. It was like, all right, you know, even when he seen Franklin point the gun at him, Reed was like, look, all right, man, we ain't even got to do this, because, you know, because I'm going to get him.
I'm going to get him.
It's a wrap. Yeah. You know what I mean? But it's like, you know.
Just that scene was intense, though, if you think about it, man, how intense that scene was, because they went from the scene, they was cutting between the scene where they was out there with his mom's pops, Alton, and Reed, and they cut to the scene with Louie and Scully, and Jerome. So they cut Jerome, to the scene. They was cutting back and forth to the scene, because, you know what I'm saying, he walked in on Louie with the pistol, you know, dripping blood and everything. And then you see Jerome. So they were just cutting back and forth. You was like, man, is he gonna kill Louie in the bed? You know what I mean? Like, and they was just cutting back and forth. And then Mom Duke stepped in, was like, look, man, we gonna fly, man. We're gonna go to Cuba, we're gonna get away, we're gonna do this. I already got the passports. And that's basically what Alton, he was like, man, I'll duck out. But I ain't going by myself, man. I want my wife with me. You know what I mean? Yeah, she kind of knew that at that moment. But you know, Reed was ready to put that thing in him right there, though. Reed was like, I gotta take him out. I can't let him go.
Yeah, it was about to be over. Reed was about to, man. Like you said, Reed was about to he's like, look, man, I love this. Basically said, I love this. I'm gonna kill you for this. You know what I mean?
Yeah, bro. Yeah, I'm going all in. I can't let you live after what, because I think he probably would have let us live, but Alton went back on the radio again.
Third strike. He did it third time, bro.
Bro, he went back on the radio again and started talking again and exposing him and talking about he got pictures. He's like, Reed's like, all right, man, this is it. I got to do it now. He's like, look, then, you know what I'm saying? Franklin called him on the phone. He's like, man, out of respect, I'm going to tell you where we going. But you know what I'm saying? Hey, you better get there on time, because it's going down.
It's going down. Like, somebody going to die. Either me and him. Die. And more likely, Reed was like, it ain't going to be me.
He already know, because soon Alton got out the car. He's like, I see you favoring your. Yeah, and he had the gun. He had the, and Reed had the pistol in the door, already ready to go. He kind of came out with his hands up. He already knew they gonna catch him off guard, gonna catch him slipping. Put the, and think about it, man. Alton ain't been shooting no pistol from that distance in a long time, and you trying to go against a trained CIA agent.
Ain't already hurt. Gun.
Yeah, and he already hurt in the dog. So you already know Reed got the upper hand on him. Reed got the upper hand on him for sure.
That was crazy, because I'm like, y'all got crept up on by Scully outside? Alton got hit by Scully. Like, come on, bro. Like, hey, you got lucky. Hey, y'all got lucky y'all got out of there.
Yeah, because Scully came in there with that sword already, let that thing go. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And they weren't even anticipating, because I think they was like, man, we're just going to go in here. We're going to talk. I'm going to try to talk them off the ledge. We're going to get them out of town. This is what we're going to do. And all of a sudden, you know, Scully come through like, look, man, I got to go in here, come check them out. I know where he live at. Like I said, they been know where he live at. They just ain't willing to go handle it. They been know where he live at, bro. And he come out the back with that sword off. You know what I'm saying? He probably been tore a hole in Alton with that sword off.
Man, tore a hole in him. But Alton hit him a couple times, and then Franklin hit him, right?
Yeah, I think he hit him in the gut, and so that's when he was at the hospital. He was bleeding, and saying he walked in the room, and Jerome saw that blood was on the floor. He already knew he was kind of weak. He was about to die.
Yeah,
and just to see Louie, like you said, that whole plan with Louie, you know what I'm saying? Talked him off the ledge, saved his life. He was like, look, because you kind of see it was in Scully's eyes. He didn't really want to do it, man. I think he was over it, bro. He was pretty much over it at that point, because she hit him with like, look, you kill me, my people gonna kill you, and it's gonna be a never ending. Everybody, you know, it's never gonna stop. And he thought about that, man.
He didn't want to do it no more. He even went back and when Khadijah was still alive, he was
he was done.
You need to get that head out your heart. He was like, man, I'm done. They killed my baby. I'm done. You know what I mean?
They killed your brother. You know what I mean? Like, they killed your brother. They killed my baby. Like, what lint they gonna do? They gonna keep killing. He was pretty much done. He felt like a lot of it was on him too, because when he strung that dude up in the baseball park, I think he had a lot to do with that. He thought God would punish him.
Yeah.
You know, if you think back a couple episodes, he thought God would punish him for stringing that boy up. And so I think he just was like, his spiritual side just kind of took over, and he was just like, man, I'm pretty much done with it. You can kind of see it in a few episodes. I was telling you, man, I think Scully done, man. And he was just trying to do that out. I think he was just like out of respect.
Like, he had to get do back. It.
Yeah, he had to do it. You know what I'm saying? They got his baby. They got his daughter. They got his, you know, got his brother. Got his, you know what I'm saying? Then he got his girl. You know what I mean? So he's like, man, I gotta go take care of it now. You know what I mean? But when he got there in that moment, as he felt his life drain away, man, he was like, man, I don't really want to do this no more. Like, I'm done with it. You know what I'm saying? She probably struck a deal with him. Like, look, man, you know, I'm gonna save your life, but this is what we're gonna do. You know, they ain't really sure, but you can kind of see when they went back to the club with Franklin. Yeah. It came back. They are, because when he came to the hospital, and Jerome like, man, we're gonna talk about it. We'll talk about it later. You know what I'm saying? They had already made their mind up that they were done.
They're
done with Franklin and being led by Franklin. Franklin, like, what you think y'all gonna do? Y'all can hold it down while I was gone. And y'all was begging me to come back.
So y'all gonna end up like Leon. You see what happened to Leon?
Yeah, you know, see what happened to Leon? Yeah, yeah. And they was like, look, but we are, and she was like, look, we already been doing it. We set up Arkansas. We got Scully. We got the projects. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna buy the bricks from you, or we're gonna do it from somebody else. You know what I'm saying? We want to keep it in the family, though.
Exactly. So, yeah, Franklin, he got a lot on his plate. You know, he got a lot on his plate. But you see, I know I'm jumping to the end right now, but you see, when he went and seen Mel, like, hey, Franklin unchanged.
Before I say that,
he cold now. Franklin cold. Like,
he about that action now.
Like, man, he went through it all. He's like, man, I'm not playing. Yeah, he like, I ain't playing.
What don't kill me make me stronger. And he's like, I ain't trying to let some of my plans blow up my future.
That boy put that cane down.
You put that cane down. Doom, he like,
doom. Hey, that boy, push I'm your push mama, it, I'm your dad. Hey, I was like, oh.
Push it, man.
Push it, man. That boy cold right now.
All right, that was so hard here with the push it, man. I want to push it, man. They was just hard, you know what I'm saying? Let them know they got off the cane. He back to it. He back in these streets. And Leon tried to quit on him. He like, nah, you ain't quit. I risked everything for you. The police, family, everybody. I risked everything for you. You ain't quit. Nah, he kind of, cause you know what I'm saying. Leon, he ready to get up, man. Leon like, man, he's like, nah, not now.
He should have let Leon go.
Nah,
he should have let Leon go, because Leon Hart ain't in it. Hey, Leon gonna mess up. Leon gonna mess him up because Leon's heart not in it. His heart not in it. Like Leon.
Yeah, but he need the project. Like I said, he need the project though. He need the project. That's his only saving grace right now. He need the projects to keep business, yeah, keep dope flowing.
That's true.
Even though he gonna have, you know what I'm saying, have it, not Khadijah, but even though he gonna have Louis and Jerome buying, you know, keys from him per week. You know, what's it gonna be? 10 keys at 12K a piece? Gonna be having them buy the key. Yep. Yeah, he trying to do the wholesale thing. They gonna be buying it from him, but he still need a project to do, you know what I'm saying, hand to hand, kind of get that money. Cause like when Reed said, man, we're gonna have to let Franklin decide. He the biggest rock dealer in the world.
In the world, bro.
I was like, bro, you think he finna let that go?
Nah. Frankly, like, nah, bro. This is me.
This is what I do.
This is what I do. I ain't going to no school. I ain't going to work for no. I mean, only person I'm gonna work. He told Reed to his face, look, I don't take kind to college threats.
That boy said, well, don't kill me, make me stronger. And I told him, hey, look, you at the Franklin Sink Foundation. Told him,
everybody out of here.
Everybody out of here. This is the Franklin. Who you think donated here? It coming from the Franklin Saint Foundation, and I am Franklin Saint. Like, huh? Yeah. And then Leon had hit old boy, let him know what it is. Like, look, it's Franklin. Hey,
back the fuck up. What are you calling? Back your ass up, nigga. Like, I said, okay. Young Leon. He said, yeah, Leon bull. Right there, you know?
Yeah, let that bull out a little bit.
Yeah.
So, man, just getting that money, man. Boy, Franklin getting that money, bro. He getting that money, man. He getting
that
big money,
bro. In the world, bro. He's like, boy, this ain't the same.
You see, you found him on the Cuba on the jet, on the private PJ?